is kijken.
You can even help with it if
you want. You want to go help?
He said you.
The fire looks cool on here.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I'm just taking off some shavings here, removing the rough, sharp corners from the cutting that I did. Yeah, I think it's still got, so like I got a little, yeah, I just showed people if they want to know what coal looks like, I got little pieces of it, you know, how it's different from the coat.
Yeah, I found
Uh-huh. So we're gonna make the handle of our Dutch lid lift. Dutch oven lid lift. You don't have that recorded, do you?
Yes, sir.
Oh, that's terrible.
I can cut it out.
That doesn't mean you will.
We're worth parts to sell it.
Making a Dutch oven lid lifter with a steer head on it. Have a longhorn steer do the heavy lifting for me. Sometimes I leave it pretty rough, so you can tell it's hammered and everything. If you want, I can smooth it up, make it more fine.
Oh no, that's fine.
I is why they call him Blacksmiths. No, does anybody here know why they're actually called Blacksmiths? It has to do actually with the color of the metal, basically. So, like, you got a goldsmith, a silversmith, and the iron is basically black. If it's a person actually that did a lot of, say, like, locks and hardware hinges, you did a lot of filing, and the metal's more white, so they actually call them whitesmiths. You know, or if someone worked with tin, it'd be a tinsmith. You know, you get all the different smiths. But yeah, the blacksmith has to do with the basic black color of the metal, not actually the color of the smith at the end of the day. But that's my joke, so. Now, one thing that's interesting, the water in the quenching tub, it's used for poison ivy. So the water in my quench tub at home, like, this gets dumped every month. But the water in my quench tub at home, they sit in there for months. And it builds up a very high level of iron from the iron being quenched in there all the time. And supposedly it's good for poison ivy rash. And there was one blacksmith, he actually sold little bottles of the stuff. Well, they called him Dr. Iron. But he sold little bottles of the slack water, as it's called. It's a slack tub out of a big wooden barrel, you know, at home. It's got the water in it. We call it a slack tub. Slack water. So it's Dr. Iron slack water. He'd sell for putting on poison ivy. Mm. That's about right.
I don't like the zoom on this thing.
So I just put that decorative twist in the handle. Yes, it came out pretty nice.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Oh, sorry. I lost my daughter as soon as we got here.
Sometimes it takes a little work. So I'm going to make the horns next for the steer.
Fitting into the bottom of the diesel stuff.
Yeah.
she ran.
Would you like to give me a hand here, volunteer?
Sure.
If you want, come on through the gate and just stand over here, and I'll hand it to you to hold for me while I chisel. It's a lift the ring and then it slides up. It's kind of a little tricky.
That big thing there, that's called an anvil.
Well, pin the ring back.
He can't figure out how to open a gate.
It works. Cows through flocks. Oh, he got it. No, the idea is to be goat proof.
It's a goat proof.
About lost my walking stick. It keeps getting in my way.
We work it right on here to start with, and once we get most of the way chiseled through, then we'll finish on here. It'll probably take us about 3 heats or so. The first heat, I'll pretty much just be working it out. And here at the end, it's pretty cold and red. Relatively up in front, we can get a little
bottom. I can't see what's going on there.
You make a set of horns. Make a spear head.
Brandon, you're too big, I couldn't see what was happening.
I'm on the side.